believe we only have 3 weeks left of school. It's gone by so fast, it's already May. All right, today we're going to work with 100 charts and adding our two-digit numbers. Sorry, guys, I had a big yawn there. You can do this page by yourself. I have no problem whatsoever of you adding 1, 2, and 3 to multiple different numbers. We're going to do this page because this page can be a little confusing. So we are on page 326 and 327, lesson 9.3, addition and exploring patterns. All right, so number 2 says, write numbers between 1 and 50 to match. So we got to find ones that answer this. So it says, all the numbers that have a 3 in the ones place. So remember when we're working with our numbers, so if we have like the number 13, this is the ones. Okay. And what is this called? This is the tens. And my pen doesn't want to work very well. So we're looking for what numbers in this chart have a 3 in the ones place. So it's easy if you can come over and you can go to the 3. And all these numbers have a 3 in the ones place. So here we're going to write 13. What comes next? 23. And then 33. And then 43. I guess I wanted you to do the 3. The 3 is in the 1's place. It doesn't have anything in the 10's place. Alright, this has the numbers that are 2 more than each number above. The numbers that are 2 more than each number above. So you're going to add 2 to each of these. So 13, add 2 is 14, 15. You can count that in your head. Or you can come over here and go 13, 1, 2. It's 15. 23 plus 2, 1, 2, 25. So go ahead and fill the rest of those in. Okay? You're going to add 2 to each of these. Now it says write numbers between 50 and 100. Now we don't have our numbers past 50 here. So this is where you would get your number chart out. Or flip to that page I said that had a hundreds chart. I need to mark it in my book so I know where it's at. Because I don't remember. Okay, but we know all the numbers that have 6 in the ones place. So we know all of these are going to have 6. And we're going to start with 50. So we have 56, 66, 76, 86, and 96. And you're going to do just like we did above and add 2 more to each of those. So 96 plus 2 would be 97, 98. Okay. So this is showing you a pattern. All these have 3's at the end. And the first number is getting bigger. All these are going to have a 5 in the ones place. And the tens place is getting bigger by 1. Same thing here. The tens place is increasing by 1. The ones place is all staying the same. So this is what your pattern is. It kind of helps you know without having to look at the chart. You know each number is going to have a 6. Each number is going to have an 8. Because you're increasing by the same amount. Oh, sorry, guys. All right. Write numbers between 11 and 50 to complete these to show different equations. So you can pick any number off of this chart between here and here and fill it in that first spot, and then you're going to add. Okay. And then down here, John has 55 cents. He gets 4 cents more. He finds 4 cents more. So we have 55 plus 4. And then Teresa has 56 cents, plus her mom gives her 2 more. Raku has 58. Who has the most money? in total? Is it John, Teresa, or Raku? So your equations is 55 plus 4 or 56 plus 2. And then Raku has 58. Who has the most money? That's what you're trying to figure out. Who has the most money? Alright guys, here's your lesson today. Finish the purple box. Finish these boxes. Okay, have a great Monday, and I will talk with you guys later.